Alright, how's everybody doing today? We're back with another gripping, thrilling, spellbinding episode of Black Mirror. In the last episode, part 5, we stumbled around a lot looking for clues that weren't there. The only real eventful thing that happened was when we had the vision, or David had the vision, of the grandfather and I guess the boy who's supposed to be his father, you know, outside like in the garden area or wherever they were. But anyway, let's go ahead and get on in here and see what we can discover today. And just in case anybody wants to know, they're like, how did he suddenly figure this out? I did look online. I had to. I was at a loss. And then when I saw what I was supposed to do or what they suggested you do, I was like, oh, that's so simple. I just had to wait for the rain to stop. So we're going to head on in here and get this going. Up, oh, hold on, let's no, I don't want settings, I want load game. God, I hate this controls on this thing. Sorry everybody, just bear with me for a second. That's what I wanted. Sorry about that. The reason you're seeing that scene there was because I had already tried to do this recording just a few minutes earlier from where I'm, you know, than now. And the game crashed. So I had to restart the recording. So let's go back to where we started the previous little recording. I'd only done about maybe 7-8 minutes, something like that. So it wouldn't, well, actually about 6 minutes. So it wasn't too bad. All right, we need to get downstairs. We know this. Okay, keep moving. No, we're not messing with the attic. We know that's kind of a dead end, at least for right now. So, get moving, David. Gosh, slow as molasses. And if I'm not mistaken, we will go over this way. Through this little entrance way here. Okay. But like I said, I started recording just a bit ago, and the game crashed during the recording, so I had to restart, which is what you're viewing right now. So hey, it'll be all good. Gosh, my mouth is hurting. I got a tooth giving me fits. Fits. Ah, here we go. And of course, the blood. She never got the blood cleaned out of there. That lazy maid. I'm going to get her. Take a broom and smack her over the head with it. Ha! Alright, now we go outside. On the grounds, finally. Finally the rain stopped. Well, this is supposed to be Scotland, like back in, you know, 1920s, 1930 range, whatever. So, you know, and it is Scotland, so I guess they do, you know, do get a fair amount of rain over there. Actually, some blue in the sky. Take a picture, David, if you can. It won't last long. Okay. Now, we had already kind of looked over this way before. There really isn't nothing over there, just some green stuff. Let's check over this way, see if there's anything to look at or key on or discover or whatever. Probably not. Yeah, nothing. Okay. And, alright. That's it, David. Get your exercise. Run around.
Master David.
Ah.
You could tell it was me.
Master David. Here's Rory, the guy that
I ken the walk of everyone here.
Eats the sardines out of the can and slurps the juice.
That's rather incredible.
Aye, that it is, laddie. That it is. I hear better than most, see more than most and all.
And he sees more than most and all. Okay, well, we got this. Oh, let's go look.
Father had us in the toolbox, back when he still fixed things around the house.
That probably is Father's toolbox. He stole it. Rory's a thief. okay, Father's hospitalization.
When you talked about what they did to my father, what did you mean?
He shouldn't have come back. You cannot go through what he did as a bairn and no be sick.
So his hospitalization was justified then?
Not for me to say. Before you think of putting down roots here, you should think on what the poison grown here did to your father. You can?
No, not really.
Okay. Leave
if
conversation.
If you didn't mind, this door will no mend itself.
I'll leave you to it then.
Yes.
Father had a similar toolbox.
Okay, nothing new there.
Back when he still fixed things around the house.
Yeah, back when he was still alive, before he went batshit crazy, or whatever happened to the poor chap. Okay, another loading screen. We even get loading screens when we're still outside. You gotta love that. Okay, now let's move up here. This must be that chapel that they were talking about. I would think so, seeing how there's a graveyard here. Oh, we gotta. Oh.
Nobody left to mourn the dead. All care for the
Well, that's the way it usually goes, David. You know, after people pass, generally, that, you know, have a grave site, and people are usually kind of keen on it. Well, let's trim up those weeds and this and that, and then over time, it just kind of, you know, the good habits with it, and then just kind of fade out. You know. Ooh, what we got here?
I've seen this before. In the painting. This is the grave I saw in that waking dream or whatever it was. The grave my father buried something in as a boy. Who's buried here?
Mm-hmm.
If I could just... these vines are too thick.
Vines are too thick. Okay. Well, obviously we're not going to be able to remove them. Well, let's go back. Let's just... You know, we don't want to leave anything undone.
I need something to cut through these.
Okay. Well, all right. I didn't think he was suddenly going to pull like a hacksaw out of his pocket or something crazy. Yep, turn around, David.
Locked with a padlock. Andrew will have a key, but I'm not keen on waiting for his return.
Quest log updated. Okay. Let's go to the quest log and see what we got. Okay, meet up with Elisa or Ailsa after dinner. Find a way into the chapel. Okay. Well, maybe Rory will have something back here. Let's go back and see old crusty old Rory. What a lovely place. Like I said, it's a perfect setting for a remake of the Munsters or Addams Family. It looks like something out of an old Dracula or Frankenstein movie from way back in the day. Let's go talk to Rory again. Maybe he's got something. Ooh, what we got here? Examine.
Look much better before the storm.
Okay. Well, be honest about it, David. Graves.
The graveyard. Is it a family plot?
Aye. No matter how high and mighty. All the Gordons end up there.
But, true.
Cheery thought.
Yes.
It's a shame we don't have the means to properly care for the graves.
Why bother? His bones and food for worms.
Key to the chapel.
You wouldn't have to have a chapel key, would you?
Ain't set a foot in there for years, and I don't intend to either.
That'll be a no then.
Bolt cutters.
May I borrow your bolt cutter?
Maybe. If I ken what you need it for.
Uncover graves.
The graves. I would like to tidy them up. That way I can pay my respects properly.
Is that a fact? Why is that then?
They are my family. They deserve to be remembered.
Well, that's true.
Fair enough, laddie. Just grab it yourself, will you?
I will. Okay. Thank you. Let me turn around. All right. Now let's go. We weren't going to say anything about cutting the lock on the chapel. Well, it's none of his business. All he is the creepy gardener. Yeah. Alright, let's go up here. Let's go over here. Excuse me. Let's go over here to the graves first, and we'll see if we can get that tidied up a bit so we know who we're talking to. All right, get around the gravestone, David. Move, move, move. Here we go. Ah, yes.
Better. Cecilia Shaw, Lee Gordon. Aunt Cecilia.
Cecilia.
No. Let's see if there's something really buried in here. Another piece of the castle model.
Ooh. Oh, nice. Because if I remember right, there was a little thing you had to stick a key in to open something on that, but we couldn't
another
do it.
Part of the model. And it's stained with what seems to be
the old blood. Ooh.
Why did Father bury this when he was a child?
To hide some secret. Okay. Well, we've done that.
How could I have known that something was buried here? I don't remember Father ever telling me about this grave. Father must have buried the chapel piece here for a reason when he was a boy. But why? And whose blood is it stained with?
We don't know. All right, well, let's head up here to the chapel. Yeah, definitely. There you go. Cut, 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 cut. There we go. Nice. Now we'll go inside the creepy chapel. Yeesh. Dreary. Quest log updated. After it gets done loading, we'll check the quest log and see what it says. Okay, explore the chapel. That's all that is. Okay. That's easy enough.
The place is crumbling. Not the safest spot to pray.
Yes, it's somewhat state of disrepair. Okay, what's this over here? Is this anything? Oh, yeah.
Father, I hope you found your peace. Were you sick, like they say you were? Or the victim of this curse? This curse of the Gordons? Whatever it is. I think you may have passed it on to me.
Okay. Oops, don't step down in there.
In
you may never get out.
Of the family Gordon, as laid down by Sir Drummond Gordon, the year of our Lord, 1413.
Good God, 500 years.
Local legend speaks of this particular glen as being inhabited from time immemorial. Enigmatic, elaborately carved Pictish stones stand as timeless evidence of this. As for the locals, they appear prideful of the counsel they delight in giving to visitors. Traveler, beware.
Beware. Okay. What we got over here? Oh, here's another one. Let's, turn around, Dave.
Celtic peoples arrived in this place like a great beast, bringing with them the bloodlines that would eventually spawn the Gordon clan. Using their superior numbers, knowledge, and machines of war, they swiftly conquered the primeval Picts. With them, they brought too their religion and druid clerics.
Druids?
The magics these wise men used did shape forever the lands, even until this present day. It is said that the sempiternal burden our family carries.
Sempiternal?
Rose at that time.
That's a big word. I have no idea what it means.
It is well recorded how the Empire of Rome did fail to tame the wayward Scots, that they did even raise a barrier to protect their mighty empire. What is seldom told is the truth behind their defeat.
Mm-hmm.
Our ancestors drew upon ancient powers to aid their victory, powers not easily fathomed by the fragile human mind.
The fragile human
this
mind.
This aid did come
okay.
at the greatest of costs. A debt as yet unsettled. A price we will continue to pay until the last Gordon passes to dust.
And, okay, another one over here. Oops.
For the centuries, we Gordons made the land our own. Others did bow to us as we kept the secrets of Scahan Dhu.
Scotland
the secrets of the Black Mirror.
The Black Mirror.
Even as tragedy and madness did fester in our foundations, we held fast and steered the land through vile English attack and worse.
And worse.
In time, the cordons and the land became one.
Okay. Anything? Oops.
Some pages have been ripped out. The only thing left seems to be some kind of family oath.
In blood we are bound to the land we protect, to the truths we alone may conceal. I shall forfeit my life, lest my clan should suffer. I shall forfeit my spirit.
You shall forfeit your life and spirit.
At bay.
Okay.
In blood we are bound till the day.
Well, this game just keeps getting creepier and weirder and weirder. Uh-oh. Okay, let's, I guess come back across the little walkway here or something. Okay. I have a feeling something very creepy is fixing to happen. And nothing over there. Oops. There we go. Well, come on. There we go. Touch.
Is this what madness feels like? It can't be real.
Uh-oh. Okay, suddenly we're underwater. Okay, very interesting. Alright, let's move around here. What are we supposed to be finding here or whatever? Touch, okay.
Ooh, this looks like the bottom of a lake.
Alright, let's and a fish.
What
or
are you
a
trying
lake.
To show me?
Yes, Mr. Fish or Mrs. Fish, what are you trying to show us? What is that? Oh, it's a body kind of floating down. Is there somebody like at the bottom of a lake or something around here? Okay. And
she's not holding a baby, but some heavy object to weigh herself down.
Ah, yes. Okay. Climb. All right, well, let's climb. Let's see what we can figure out here. If anything, you know. Climb. Okay, no, that's just for that. Climb?
I feel like I've missed something.
You feel like you've missed something?
I feel like I've missed something.
Okay, well then, let's, come on, David. Let's go back down here. Okay, nothing there. So let's take a quick move over this way. Nothing. Okay, we're kind of in just in this little tight area. And it's not letting us do anything else, I guess, where that body's kind of floating down. So, okay, well, let's climb. There's nothing else I can do. Oh, wait. No, that's not what I want to do. I mean, you gotta be, like, right on these things, you know? To really, you know, be able to... There we go. I mean, you got to click it just right. Ooh. Ooh, very creepy. Looks like he's about ready to... Ah! What did I do? What did I do? Now, that's the first time I've seen that, that you could actually die in the game. Okay. That was a little different. Please tell me I don't have to go through the whole chapel thing again and read all them stones. Apparently, I'm going to have to. Oh, man. Sorry, everybody. Sorry. Yep.
Being the Chronicle, local has for...
Since we've already read through these, I'll just skip through them real quick.
Using with them, as it said.
Okay, read this one.
What is our answer? This aid for the centuries.
Yeah, like I said, let's just skip through the dialogue. We've already heard it if you're watching the video. No sense in having to go through all that again.
In blood we to the land, to the true I shall forth, lest my clan. I shall forfeit
my spirit, the darkness at bay, and blood were bound. Okay. Okay, now let's come back across here. Because we knew that's what we had to do. Okay, here we go. Touch.
Is this what madness feels like? It can't be real.
It can't be real. Trust me, David. I think it is real. And I think you are starting to experience the madness. That's right. We got to go up over here to this thing here. Okay. Yeah, the underwater flora. Okay.
This looks like the bottom of a lake.
Yes, it does. All right, let's move on. Move along here. And let's go talk over here to Mr. Fish. Or Mrs. Fish, as I was saying before. Creepy. All right, let's see what we got here.
She's not holding a baby, but some heavy object to weigh herself down.
Okay, climb. Now let's see if we can get this right, because I was like lost the first time. I'm like, okay, what's going on here? Very weird.
I feel like I've missed something.
Yeah, you have missed something, David. Let's come back over this way. And,
the figure up there must be Edward.
That's Edward. Edward. Okay, now we can climb. Now we got past that. I just didn't hit the X button enough, I guess, or the action button, you know. That's very weird. It's hard to see. Where's my character? Ah! No! Back! Back away from the darkness. The evilness, or whatever. Okay, it's like something pops up there. There we go. No. Daggone it. You gotta time it just right. It's so fucking finicky. Let's stand right here and let's wait for Edward to pop back up again.
A note.
There we go.
I'm taking my baby with me to save it from this rotten family.
David! Oh, God. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh, who is that? Who is that?
Are you all right?
Oh. All right, let's get this in here. Let's get it in here. Let's keep it in here so we can end this madness. Okay, there we go.
Did you see her? She drowned.
Trophy earned 20,000 miles under the sea.
Okay. What are you doing clambering about in here?
Because I can.
If I told you, you'd think me mad.
Aunt, that is just what your father said to me.
Who are you?
Who are you?
My name is Dr. Lea Faber. I treated your father at the asylum.
Oh,
the asylum.
Lea Faber. Well, what are you doing here? Sure, if father's right. Done, dead, and whatever. Weird. Very weird. Well, now we have another new character, Dr. Lea Faber. Most interesting, I guess, in a kind of roundabout way. Come on, loading screen. Just... All right, let's get through this cutscene here. Oh, David. I think you like her, David. Why
what
is she here?
What did you come here for?
I'm not sure your father's story is finished yet, and there are some things I still need to make my peace with.
Oh, you do?
What's
asylum?
What's this about an asylum?
As I said, your father was admitted.
Why?
Sorry
who
if this might be
him?
A little bit longer video, everybody. I'm going to get it all
but
in here.
Unfortunately, he managed to escape.
What? Hold on a minute. How dare you come in here and...
Told you? Your father was a madman. A complete and utter madman. Don't mind me. Please continue.
You need to shut up.
Well, what right did you have to lock my father up in a madhouse?
I was his doctor. I understand you are in shock, but you have no right to speak to me in such a way. I was trying to help him.
You're in my house.
He's dead.
I will
Capital
speak to you
child.
However I wish.
Now, hold on just a minute.
Good lady. What the heck was that? Well, now everybody's going Looney Tunes up in here. Okay. What? Can we just move along with this loading screen? I hate these. One every once in a while, okay, but not like this.
Oh, Jesus! Oh, no!
Uh-oh. What? What is it? What are we looking at? I want to see. Show me. It's the maid. The maid who was scared of her own shadow is dead. Boy, this is really getting weirdo city. Okay, I mean, can we move it along? Why just slowly pan it out? I mean, that's very slow. Whew. And another loading screen. Of course, we gotta have another loading screen. Chapter 2 completed. Well, I hadn't seen that before, so I guess that's a good thing. I don't know how many chapters are in the game. I never thought to look. I guess I'll have to check and just kind of give me a general idea what's going on.
Eddie, it'll be all right. Pull yourself together.
I suggest nobody else goes down there. We should keep the room intact until the police can get here.
I shall alert them first thing in the morning. What an unfortunate accident.
It was not an accident.
You think so? Just after the madman's son turned up at our door.
And yet you were the one standing over her body with blood on your hands.
How dare you? I was too late. I was trying to help her. She...
How dare I? This ain't your house.
There,
get out.
My sweet boy. Let's get you to bed. Angus, would
figures the old bag's gotta put her 2 cents in.
I think we will all benefit from a good night's sleep.
Oh, yeah. Everybody's just gonna go to sleep like a baby.
I know
you with a madman running about.
I need you to trust me. I'm the only one on your side when it comes to your father's death.
Lady Margaret certainly isn't. But if I told you what I saw in the chapel, you'd have me in a padded cell just like my father.
Yes, right, you would. All right, well, let's keep it just for a couple more minutes here. About John.
What was my father like when you locked him up?
I didn't just lock him up. I tried to help him. Your father was heavily drugged when he was brought to me. It was to prevent any further violent outbursts. Or so Lady Margaret had said. But something felt wrong, even then.
Why did you
come here? To make sure my father was successfully in the ground?
With all due respect, Mr. Gordon, I will not allow you to speak to me or about my work in such a tone. I tried everything I could
to get
your
father. We don't need you here.
He was convinced he was carrying some ancient curse, that he was being haunted by evil. I wish I had reached him, had been able to help him.
You're a failure.
So do I.
Yeah.
You're the only one who couldn't reach him. You're a persistent one, aren't you? Maybe if I threw you a bone, you'd get off my back.
Uh-huh.
Father was obsessed with the history of the family for as long as I can remember.
Did your father actually believe his family was out to get him?
Who knows? I think what scared him was beyond the physical. He used to babble about
ancient
a dark
evil.
Force threatening him and our family.
Was that why he moved you to India? To get as far away as possible?
I believe so.
Possibly.
And yet, here you are. In the very place he sought to protect you from.
Who knows?
Well, at least the game has really taken a turn to get a little more interesting.
An evil that drags us back no matter how far away we get. Even from the other side of the world.
And what do you think? Was your father right? Are there things beyond the physical?
I have other things to worry about right now. Things like a drowning woman floating in thin air. If you really want to help me, I need to find out what the maid knew. What Lady Margaret and Angus didn't want her to tell me.
You believe it got her killed?
Maybe.
Possibly, yes.
Chapel. It has to be real. She must have drowned herself down at the loch. Because if it's all in my mind, like father, like son.
Okay. Wow. A whole lot happened in this episode, everybody. But I'm going to go ahead and end this video here. I do appreciate everybody come watching. Like I said, this is a little bit longer video, but I mean, there was so much going on and it just kept going and going. But anyway, all kinds of new stuff, new mysteries, and a death of the maid. But I appreciate everybody watching. Please throw up your like, hit the subscribe, you know, all that good stuff. And I'll have more of this here very quick, very soon. I want to see what's going on here too. But everybody have a good day. Thanks for watching, and we'll talk to y'all later on.